In an unprecedented move, media organisations from across the country have come together in a united protest against government secrecy and cover-ups. Nine Political editor Chris Yorman joins us now from Canberra. Chris, good morning to you. The campaign's called Your Right to Know and it's a fight for press freedoms. We've never seen anything like it before in Australia, have we? Just explain how it's come about.
No, look, getting the media together is really like herding cats. A lot of different media organisations usually fight amongst themselves rather than work together. But what's brought this to a head are two raids that happened in June, one on a journalist's home, Annika Smethurst from News Limited, and one on the offices of the ABC, where police went in hunt of information to try and track down the people who had handed over documents to the media, telling them things that really people had a right to know. Annika Smethurst's story was about the fact that the Australian Signals Directorate, which is the organisation which looks into spying on organisations overseas on behalf of the Australian government, may well at some future point have the opportunity to act inside Australia. Now, I think that that's something that the Australian people at the very least would like to be able to debate. So it's come to a head because of those two raids.
A transparent and accountable government is a cornerstone of democracy, and research shows Australians want that, they expect that, but many think this doesn't affect them. Just give our viewers some real examples, if you could, Chris, of where the government is withholding information and denying us the truth.
Well, a lot of people would like to know whether or not the aged care home that they might put their parents into has or hasn't been involved in abusing elders. Now, those statistics are released over years. People have tried to break that down to get information on which particular homes have been a problem. There's a Royal Commission on that at the moment. You still can't find out where that's a particular problem inside Australia. You might be interested in knowing that the Australian Tax Office can go directly to your account and take money out of it without your permission when it starts debt collecting. Now, because of a whistleblower, we do know that now. He faces 161 years in jail because of a series of stories that were done about the Australian Taxation Office. So around Australia, I think that we like to believe that we are a transparent democracy, but when you look at comparable places like the United Kingdom or the United States, we are much less transparent.
Yeah, we're one of the most secretive governments in the world. The campaign wants change to six critical areas of law. What will happen if these laws aren't changed?
Well, simply all that the media is asking for is some of the protections which are enjoyed in the United States and the United Kingdom. Now, we're never going to get the First Amendment rights that they have in the US. In the US, it's against the law for Congress to pass laws which limit the rights of the media. Now, that's how old this debate is. It goes back, you know, more than 200 years. In the UK, there's conventions which protect the rights of the media. There's nothing similar here. And one of the things that we'd like to do is simply to be able to contest the fact that the police may be about to raid a journalist's home or an organisation, a media organisation. So that's simply to have a debate in an open court where that can be contested.
Chris, has there been any response from the government on this yet, other than claims that this campaign is purely media self-interest?
Well, of course, they'd say it's media self-interest, but they do recognise that the media plays an important role in democracy. And I'd just say to your viewers this morning that many of the things that we discuss every single day are things that are revealed by journalists. A lot of the water cooler conversations at work, a lot of the things that matter to people really have their birth in reporting that's been done by journalists. So the government is talking a good game, says that it believes in media freedom, but at this stage we're not seeing any significant movement by the government.
All right, and just finally, of course, this campaign does require our viewers' support, doesn't it?
It does. Go to yourrighttoknow.com.au and you can follow the links there and express your view on this. And I say it's not just the Australian government, by the way, it's every level of government in Australia, local, state and federal, tend to be more secretive than comparable governments around the world.
Yeah, it is a very important issue indeed. Chris Yorman from Canberra, we appreciate it. Thank you.